In the previous section, I stated that some level of pesticide residue is formed after any pesticide application. Residues decline over time. The Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, conducts a thorough risk assessment for each registered active ingredient. There are now over 1,000 of them. EPA uses all the information gathered during the risk assessments to determine an acceptable level of pesticide residue that can be allowed on food and feed products or commodities, and sets a residue tolerance for each one of them. Tolerances set by the EPA are published in the Code of Federal Regulations, CFR. A tolerance is the maximum amount of pesticide residue that's allowed to be on food or feed products at the time of harvest. Other countries set tolerances too, but call them maximum residue limits, MRLs. Tolerances are not only established for the active ingredient, but also for any byproducts, metabolites, or reaction products that may result from a pesticide being broken down after application. These tolerances are set to protect the consumer from harmful levels of pesticides on food or feed. There are no differences in residue tolerances among the states. All states follow the federal tolerance levels set by EPA. Tolerances are specific to each active ingredient used on a specific crop. So the tolerance for an active ingredient on peaches could be very different than the tolerance for that same active ingredient on cabbage or another commodity. Note that if there is no tolerance level stated for a certain active ingredient on a crop, then that means any residue found is illegal. On the other hand, some active ingredients are exempt from the requirement of a tolerance. This is the case only for a few pesticide active ingredients that are considered to be less toxic or less harmful. As I explained earlier, EPA sets the tolerance limits for each pesticide that may be found on food or feed. The U.S. Department of Agriculture, USDA, enforces tolerances for meat, poultry, and some egg products, and the Food and Drug Administration, FDA, enforces tolerances for other food. In this way, these federal agencies ensure that the nation's food supply is safely maintained at all times. In 2005, Canada's Pest Management Regulatory Agency and EPA harmonized tolerances and MRLs to minimize trade barriers of pesticide-treated commodities between the United States and Canada. Specific tolerance levels for each pesticide active ingredient and individual crops can be accessed and searched through the EPA website. Monitoring pesticide residues is a costly exercise conducted by the California Department of Pesticide Regulation and will be explained in the next section. It is important for you to understand that the EPA risk assessment process assures that the applied product will stay within the tolerance or the legal residue limit, even if you apply the maximum allowed rate and the maximum number of applications with the shortest interval of time before harvest. Ignoring the pesticide label instructions may result in illegal residue. Illegal means that the produce has a residue that either exceeds the legal limit, tolerance, or that is from a pesticide not registered for use on that commodity. A harvested crop with illegal residues cannot be sold and must be destroyed. In the next section, you will learn about the residue monitoring process in California.